Hi, in this tutorial we will learn how to create 2D sections from 3D objects. I have two objects here, and let's say I want to take sections from these two objects, horizontal sections at a specific interval. I will type contour, press enter, it will ask me for the objects. I will choose both of the objects, then enter. Now I need to show Rhino the direction, so I will click here. It doesn't matter where, just I will click here, then because I want my sections to be from down up, I will press shift to constrain the movement of my mouse, and then I will click. Now Rhino knows that my sections will go from here up vertically. Now I need to tell Rhino at which interval I need my sections to be here. Now it is 5 millimeters. That means the first section will be here at the bottom, then Rhino will jump 5 millimeter and take another section, then another 5 millimeter, and another section. Now I will accept this value now, and I will click enter. Watch here, after clicking enter, what's going to happen. Now I will click enter. As you can see, sections are created. It's very easy to do. I will delete those. I will repeat this operation. I pressed enter to repeat the last command, which is contour. Now I will choose the objects, enter. Let's say I want my sections to be from down up but not vertical. I can click here, and let's say I want my sections to be, you know, at an angle. I clicked here. I will accept this 5 thing and enter. See, as you can see, I will delete those. And again, let's say I want my sections to be, you know, vertical in this direction. So I can right click on the command, and you can see the list of the last commands I used. I choose contour, select the objects, enter, then I will click here and I will press shift, and then I will click enter. As you can see, my contours, my sections are created. Again, I will delete those. Let's talk about some options in the contour. I will press enter because it was the last command, so I can bring back the contour command by pressing enter. Let's start with this one, group objects by contour plane. Now it is no. What this does, when the section created, let's say in this case I have two objects, so if I say yes, the contours that are at the same level, even from different objects, will be grouped together. We will see this now. I will choose the objects, enter, I will click, shift and click, then enter. I have my contours. Now, this is the first here. This circle here, it's at the same level as this one. So if I click on this one, as you can see, they are both grouped together. Of course, I can ungroup these two by go here and then click ungroup. So now both are ungrouped. These are grouped together. Okay. Again, let's see what we have also. Press enter. Oh. The last command was ungroup. So right click, contour. Range. So if I choose range, it will let me decide at which level the contours will start to be created. If I don't want the contours to start from the bottom until the end, I can choose a range, let's say from here to here. So I can now, where I click, it's important. Let's say I want the section to start from here. I will press shift and I stop here. I will accept this 5 thing, enter. As you can see, only from here to here sections are created. I will delete those and then I will press enter again. You have this option, assign layer by current layer. Now what this does, if I use this current layer, it means that this current layer, you see a check on it, the sections created will be placed in this layer because it is the current one. Of course I can change the current by clicking here. So if I choose, I have an option to say input objects. Now in this case, the sections created, those created from this object will be placed in its layer. This object is in a layer called objects, and this object is in a layer called cylinder. So the sections, the circles created from this cylinder will be placed in cylinder layer, and the sections created from this object will be placed in the layer called objects. And well, basically that's it. It's very easy and very useful. Thank you for watching.